know, we let it slip. We didn't earn it in the end. We had the opportunity to earn it. That's basically it in a nutshell. And they got a breach, good tackle line breach down the the main stand side there, which was ended up being the point of difference. Yeah.
Just it might be, I suppose, easy to focus on that, but in that first half the four penalties, the corner that you guys didn't get rewarded, that must have also been disappointing.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's ultimately Maris is a referee that, if you're cynical in that area, he generally goes to card very early. On this particular occasion, he didn't, for some unknown reason. Still getting a lot of guys at the back of malls, and it's an easy out to say that they came through. Swimming is, I think, the term they call it. There seems to be a lot of guys ending up in the back of malls, which is not ideal.
David
Pocock
had quite a big influence as well in that first half.
Yeah, no, he's a good player, David. When we went to the middle of the field, short on numbers a couple of times, he had an influence on the ball. He's a very experienced player, and if he's tackler, if he can dominate the tackle or be a tackle assist, he's always going to have a real big impact on the ball. Yeah, well, see, they were on a warning as well. I thought there was possibly one decision where I think we chose to take it to eight, and we could have gone to the corner at that point when they went to on the red card. I think that was probably a decision that we would look back on and maybe have gone to the corner instead. Influenced the game at that point. So, but at the end of the day, whenever there's a poor performance, the first person I look at is myself. I take responsibility. I look to see where we failed the group in preparation. Without making excuses, we are becoming very, very thin up front. We do have a lot of players developing in Super Rugby, and we didn't get what we thought we should have got out of finishing the game. So unfortunately, that's part of the evolution that we're going to actually have to go through. There's no magic solution to this. We've lost Marco to a lengthy injury, I think, and also Ruloff tonight as well. So the numbers are climbing in terms of injuries to the forwards.
John, what's with Ruloff? Marco, obviously.
I think Ruloff has to be fully diagnosed, but I think it's MCL, and Marco is maybe a fracture of some sort here in the ankle. I just saw him on the stretcher going into the ambulance. Just
great. You've got now 3 weeks, a couple of weeks off. How are you guys going to handle that? How many of the guys will be back?
Yeah, we'll be back in on the second week for two major days, and then we're back in on the fourth week for a full weekly process before we come in for the Sunwolves preparation. So we'll just have to collect numbers and see what we've got left in terms of playing resources, because Lucy's are starting to get thin. We're maximising the locks, and as you know, up front in the front row, especially the props, we're also managing that area as well.
John, when you look back at the last few weeks, and the fact that you guys have played for about 6-7 games now in a row, would that contribute to obviously the injuries that you before you guys? And
yeah, it's been a long haul, but that's what it was, and we planned for it. So you can't deal for acute injuries. It hasn't been muscular. Yeah, a lot of it's been proper collisions. She's a relentless competition, and it demands a lot of you mentally. The guys have prepared very, very well, but today we got untidied at the wrong point in the match, which of course talked about as the last 20 minutes we had that opportunity to earn it, and we let it slip.
Do you also feel John, that you guys had those soft moments, especially in the first half. I mean, you scored immediately after scoring, you let them back, let them score as well.
Yeah, no, I mean, that was unfortunate. That happens, though. But, you know, you don't let that unsettle you, which it didn't. We actually held our composure, you know, very well, even up to, you know, even in the situation of the red card. And but we were, the try just after half time, I think it was, that was you know, two players missing detail, which was a concern.
John, just in terms of playoffs now, is it gone?
It's certainly going to make it a lot more difficult. Would have been nice to have got it today and kept winning. So yeah, now we just again just got to now restock, refuel, and focus on each game at a time. So so that's the way it is.
And just if in terms of you look back 6 months ago, to pre-season to where you are now, the June break, are you satisfied with the progress that a lot of the guys have made?
Oh, we've made progress, but we've also shown some developmental issues and concerns. I think there's also some positional concerns for, you know, looking at the stock of talent. So clearly, but I'll wait till the end of the competition to look at where I think we need to continue to grow those stocks. As I said before, we're very, very light at loosies at the moment, and we're very, very light in front row. We're at a point now where we're bringing in development players that are probably not ready for Super Rugby in my view.
Does it sort of change your mind on continuing with the, obviously with the younger players and
it just doesn't work bringing people in. They've got to learn to understand how we do things, and so yeah, the important thing is to make sure that we get the best out of what we have at the moment and continue to develop those players. And obviously some guys are going to be presented opportunities now that and they need to seize it, but I think we will be better for a break as well.